Hi, I'm Vivek Kumar from Inventor Architects at Ayadi Chennai. It's a partnership firm. We've been doing the practice from 2008 onwards. For us, design and concept is not a single layer. It always comes from different factors like site, surroundings, neighbor, and user, and also the lifestyle. So it is a multi-layer implementation rather than experimentation. We work closely with the clients to understand and experience the space which we are created. Client was a businessman who wants to build a house for his son who was studying in abroad. He wanted to build a house in contemporary design style, but father insists to go for a traditional principle like Ayadi Shastra. In this project, he want to explore, he want to go in depth to do it as a full Vastu house. Ayadi Shastra is that it gives the outer dimension of the building. Ayadi Shastra, it gives the inner space of that room. And as a grid, it gives that structural for the building, and five elements like earth, water, sky and fire is a unifying component for that both interior and exterior. Site is located in East Coast Road, 3 blocks away from Bay of Bengal. It's a private villa property development, almost like a square-ish plot. The extent of 5.5 grounds. Based on the traditional principle, the building was placed at the southwest quadrant of the site. Similarly, swimming pool also placed accordingly. If anyone enters, the person would walk through an inviting wide entry accompanied by larger landscape and water bodies. Sitting Buddha and lily pond, it gives the calmness anyone enters before to the building. When it comes to planning, outer dimension of the building was derived from the bazaar of the head and divided by 9 sectors and further divided into 9 grids to order to maintain the proportion and detail vastu, and structure was integrated by pushing the column in that grids. The center portion was left out as a void. It is called Brahmasthana. The house was divided by 2 axes, X and Y. X axis gives that horizontal movement or circulation. Y axis gives that vertical movement or circulation, which accommodate the staircase and lifts. Based on the traditional principle, that particular functions were placed superimposed. So kitchen was placed at the southeast corner of the house, is called Agni Mula for fire, and master bedroom was placed at the southwest corner, it is called Gubaira Mula. Toilet and bedroom placed at the northwest corner, called Vayu Mula for fire. So anyone enters to that main door, they could not see any walls in front of that. In order to have that single larger living and dining space, and northeast corner, we placed that office space, and the center of the house, the puja was placed facing on east. We were planned to have a panchas. The one which is on front side facing on east called veranda. Another one adjacent to the dining is called sit out. The larger one which is facing on north, it allows that outer landscape to the building to be part of it. In that first floor, the another 2 bedroom was placed as same as ground floor, and we had a home theater on southeast corner above that kitchen, and larger L-shaped family room were planned to have a panoramic view to the sea and as well as the greenery are designed in that side. The central space remains as a cutout, as a lung space courtyard, and both side of that courtyard is a connecting element. It acts as a bridge where the person who can have more interaction in that place. In this house, we didn't have that individual balconies for the bedroom. Insist, we had a larger sit-out. It comes in the front, in above the car park, so that family members can have that interaction more. When it comes to the second floor, the 50% of the area is left out as a used terrace. Another bedroom and gym were accommodated in the same level. The center courtyard remains as continuous a triple eight space, and staircase spirally runs to the top floor. The house also vertically staggered, being a southwest portion as a starlet as per Vastu, and which facilitates the maximum view towards the sea at each level. Normally, once architecture is done, interior follows. The traditional principle was carried out in detail to link the both architecture and interior. Anyone enters to the residence, easily they could relate, understand the concept of five elements through the detail from that compound wall and gate into the to the extent of toilet mirror in the various form of color, texture and shape. So pebbles bit in the front of Buddha, and the person moves forward, they can see that main door where planned to have five elements in abstract manner as a metal plate, and moves further, the left side can see that five mirrors and Arthangudi customized tiles along with the pattern and dining mirror and staircase opening along with that customized wall mural and handrail around that courtyard and service decks in the rear. So courtyard is a dynamic place of the building where you can see that roof. It has a circular opening, it acts as a light well. We wanted to have indirect lighting, positiveness and energy. We were planned to have a Vastu chakra as a CNC in an abstract manner. It casts the shadow at different time and different place. Staircase is the second important element to the house. You would like to go for a light fitting as an ethnic style. Every alternate steps are projected as a cantilever to accommodate that ethnic light. During the night and day, it looks like a divas. And multiple glass chandelier that comes from the roof, it gives the visual connectivity to the entire house. He wanted to have a villa which reflected wherein a person would experience a mystic connection with the space. Concept or design does not have to be explained, but experienced. Thank you.